The message of the hour is startled. Watch ye therefore, for ye know not the hour. Please welcome Pastor Dave Monet Nyengwe. God bless you.
Oh, God, help me, let this one go. Some who have not enslaved him now will participate. But when you see, oh God, I am in ages past, many will keep quiet. Alright? As you go towards the end of the world, so many things will go wrong. Make sure leaders of the church try to bring them back. Organize, follow them. And when you are playing the last hymn, the last stanza, don't keep us waiting. Don't keep us waiting. Just play the last line. Bye-bye. And then we'll see. But for us to keep waiting, suddenly we start singing again. That's not the idea. When that was happening, when we used to do that, it was when we had grand piano. Grand piano, no microphone. By the time we sing stanza one, stanza two, three, the communication had gone off key. Then the organist will now cue us back with the grand piano the last time. Then we'll come back to the key or the pitch. But today, we have this powerful instrument. You may decide not to stop and we sing all through. But if you want to play it back, just the last line, the last line. The beginning again. Now we'll sing the last, the first and the second stanza, and it will do it for us. Give us the key again.
Also, the melody he provided.
God. The scientists, astronomers, and astrophysicists told us something that he said was on its way coming to us. A big object, very big, coming not from within our solar system. Our solar system, we have planet Earth, we have Venus. Am I right? We have Mercury, Venus, we have Earth, we have Mars, we have Jupiter, then we have Saturn. Am I right?
Yes.
We have Saturn, Neptune, Uranus, name them, all them line up.
Me too.
Together, all of them go around the sun. We call it our solar system. That is the planets around our own sun. But this that is coming is coming outside of our solar system and heading to our solar system. Right now, it is where they call the old clouds, and speeding and coming towards us, speeding. It will get to us here in January 2031. 10 years from now, it will be here. But you know, they say we shouldn't worry, we shouldn't be afraid. The head, equatorial line, I can use that, of the object, is about 100,000 kilometers, about 100,000 kilometers wide. And the circumference all around it, is about 250,000 kilometers. That's big. The equatorial diameter of our planet, where we are, of our planet, is 80,000 miles, which is about 12,000 kilometers. Are you hearing me very well? The circumference, our planet, go around it, is about 25,000 miles or 40,000 kilometers. Now, Roman Christian, listen. The head or the measurement of our head, equatorial, is about 12,000 kilometers. That one is 100,000 kilometers wide. Our size is about 40,000 kilometers. That one is 250,000 kilometers. Why? What do you think will happen if he comes here?
Knock off the whole earth.
Jesus says there will be signs and wonders. The powers of heaven shall be what? Shaken. Don't say he didn't warn us. He told us, he said, watch. The third stanza we sang there says, every woman, do what? Every woman discerning, 1886. Joseph Belden, F.T. Belden wrote it, 1886. Every woman discerning, try to find out what is happening. That's exactly what I'm doing with you now. That object is heading towards us. About 9.5 years now from now, it will enter our solar system. They have said we shouldn't worry. That's not a problem. But the problem I have is that those objects that come outside of our solar system, they are not normal. They operate not the way we operate here. When we enter, they misbehave. October 2017, one enter. The first one ever came in, small, 1 kilometer long. The name they gave it was Uwamuamu. Uwamuamu. Let me spell it so that you can check it out. The internet, you can check it out on your Google. Uwamuamu is O-U-A-M-U-A. Uwamuamu. Water according to physics, water boils at 100 what? Degrees what? Celsius. Very hot. But then, the sun, the heat or the hotness of the sun is 6,000 degrees Celsius. Not 600, 6,000 degrees Celsius. Water, only 100 degrees, water will boil. Umama came close to the sun like this and passed through the sun. Say, good morning, sun, how are you? Passed by the sun like this, the sun didn't touch it, nothing, nothing. Didn't feel any hotness of the sun. It passed. It didn't change. It remained what it was. This covenant, since it passed through by the sun and headed towards us. When it got to the orbit of Mars, as it got to the orbit of Mars, after Mars it will have come to us. What did it do? Look like this. Wow. It changed its course. By the time scientists got ready to photograph it and look at it, it has gone. It behaved like intelligence. Something operated it. Just come like this. And it changed its course. And avoided us. It avoided us. And headed out. Out. So this one that is coming, that we enter Saturn, they say no problem, no problem. Supposing it changes its course. Because you can't predict. In fact, the scientists are saying that a lot of surprises in our solar system. But you're always surprised the things they do. You can't predict what will happen. They are saying by 2031 it will be here, which is correct. But then what happens next? They say we shouldn't be afraid. God's children, are you going to be afraid?
No.
Don't be afraid. But I want to tell you this. Listen very carefully. I want to tell you this. Jesus was baptized AD 27. What year?
AD 27.
Jesus was baptized AD 27. In Luke chapter 3, Luke tells us that Jesus was baptized in the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar. That's Luke chapter 3. Accurate. Tiberius Caesar in history, the 15th year was AD 27. AD 27, down the line, 6 years from now, will be 2027. Am I right? Am I right? 6 years from now will be 2027. AD 27 to 2027 will be 2,000 years. Jesus.